Hello everyone, I'd like to apologize for the confusion on my last video. In the haste of making it, I failed to notice that it was the 2016 variant that I was running, and not the current variant of Petya that infected computers around the globe. So here now, we have Petya, aka NotPetya, with special thanks to Polar Toffee on Twitter for helping with the sample and getting it running. Before we take a look at it, we have some dummy files here that will be encrypted, a VBS script message box, another VBS script from the System32 directory, and some C code, which is very cool. When run, we see that it deletes the executable, in this case a DLL file, from the desktop and begins its encryption. Our cool code is no more, and our scripts are unreadable and unusable. If we look at the scheduled tasks, the ransomware has set up a task to restart the computer 1 hour and 3 minutes from now. It uses other methods to restart the computer, but this will restart it if those fail. We can see on the other computers that the dummy files are still intact. Checking in a while later, we can see that computer 3 has been infected as well, and its files have been encrypted. Computers 2 and 4 are safe, for now. If we look at the contents of the files here, we can actually see that they're different depending on which computer was infected. Before the scheduled task is reached, all the computers are infected, and it begins rebooting them so that it may encrypt the master file table of each hard drive. The computers start to reboot, and once they come back up, they show the ransomware's fake scan disk message. As it encrypts the master file table of each computer, it is still possible to save some data if the computers are shut off now. However, if left to completion, eventually they will display Petya's ransomware message. Computer 3 gets there first, shortly followed by Computer 4. We can see that Computer 2 is coming in close behind it at 98%, however Computer 1 has fallen way behind and is still at 58%, and will take several more minutes to complete the fake scan disk and display the ransomware message. For whatever reason, VirtualPC 2007 really wants to try to network boot after the master file table has been overwritten, so we just go ahead and restart each virtual machine in order to get it to display the ransomware message. At long last, all of the virtual machines have been encrypted, all starting from a single infection point that spread throughout the network and encrypted everything it could find. Shortly after the ransomware became known, the email address you see here was shut down, making it impossible to recover your files. However, on top of that, it's almost impossible to recover your files anyway because of bugs in the code that render your files corrupted instead of just encrypted. So that's about it for the Petya ransomware. Thank you very much for watching. Hope you enjoyed seeing it spread. And I'll be seeing you next time. If you'd like some more reading on the subject, there are some links in the description that cover this ransomware in much more detail, especially as new details emerge on this very new threat. Thanks again for watching. Take care.